ang katawan at nagiging matibay ang buto upang maiwasan ang sakit. Araw-araw, take GuardC Calcium Ascorbate for a more active lifestyle. Katawang healthy. Achieve sa GuardC.
Ang susunod na programa ay rated PG. Patnubay at gabay ng magulang ay kailangan sa mga batang manonood.
Talk, Sir Jen. Magandang our topic is the spot market or WESM. Will it benefit Mindanao or not? Mga kabrigada, the Electric Power Industry Reform Act, or EPIRA of 2001, particularly Section 30, provides that the market shall provide the mechanism for identifying and setting the price of actual variations from the quantities transacted under contracts between sellers and purchasers of electricity. Kaya po, nabuo ang Wholesale Electricity Spot Market, or WESM. Ang WESM po aims to establish a competitive, efficient, transparent, and reliable market for electricity, and this is according to the rules found in Section 1.2.5. Ang WESM ay merkado sa bentahan ng kuryente. Ang WESM ay nag-operate lamang sa Luzon at Visayas, wala pa po sa Mindanao. Ano ba ang WESM? The Wholesale Electricity Spot Market, or WESM, is a venue for trading electricity as a commodity. Ito po ay merkado ng bintahan ng kuryente. Sa WESM po, bibili ng kuryente ang ating mga electric co-ops, distribution utilities at malalaking industries na malalaki po ang konsumo ng power supply. Kung may kakulangan sila na hindi po nakasaad sa kanilang mga kontrata with generating companies or GenCos, ay bibili po sila sa WESM. Ang WESM ay created by virtue of Section 30 of Republic Act Number 9136, otherwise known as the Industry or the Electric Power Industry Reform Act or EPIRA of 2001. Ngayong umaga po mga kabrigada, we have a special guest with us. And allow me to introduce him on TV. Ito po mga kabrigada ang aking introduction. He graduated from the Mindanao State University in Marawi City with a bachelor's degree in electrical engineering. Meron po siyang 35 solid years of work experience in electric power system engineering, electric distribution, utility operations, and corporate management. He initiated the venture of the Sepalco Group of Companies for the construction of run-of-river hydroelectric power plants and solar power plants. And at present, siya po ay nakikibaka, an advocate and lobbying. He is the president of the Mindanao Coalition of Power Consumers, or MCPC, based in Cagayan de Oro City, although he serves the entire Mindanao region. Please help me welcome Engineer David Tauli. Good morning po, sir.
Good morning. Yes. Morning, Belinda.
Please greet our audience.
Hi, good morning to you all. Thank you for the opportunity for trying to make people understand what is the WESM.
Yes, what is WESM? So, ang tawag ko po sa'yo, sir, engineer or sir?
Dave.
Dave, okay. Sir Dave.
I'm Dave.
Okay, Sir Dave, since nag-greet mo na po ang ating mga kabrigada at napaka-technical po ang ating topic, mga kabrigada, kasi ito po ay electricity. At alam naman po natin na kung sa kuryente po, ang mga tao ay medyo ayoko niyan, basta magbabayad lang ako ng power consumption ko, tapos na ang aking relationship with power. Hindi po ganun kasimple, mga kabrigada, kung gusto po nating matutunan kung ano ba talaga ang intricacies sa power system, ay pwede po tayong makibahagi at mag-aral. At ngayon po ay talagang we are very privileged to have with us Sir Dave, na siya po ay tatalakayin po niya ang tungkol sa WESM. O Sir Dave, start na tayo ha. We'll start the ball rolling.
Okay.
Una sa lahat po, nais ko pong malaman at malaman ng ating mga kabrigada kung ano po ba ang WESM or ang merkado ng bintahan ng kuryente sa Luzon at Visayas, at kung ito po ba ay beneficial para sa mga consumer sa Luzon at Visayas.
Right. We need to define WESM really, because there are WESMs and there are WESMs. Uh-huh. And right now, sa ngayon, what is being sold in Mindanao is not really a WESM. I would call it a fake WESM.
Okay.
So what is a WESM? if you strip it of all of its legalese, mm-hmm. tanggalin mo lahat mga yan, at the end of it, what the WSM will do is to enable all consumers to have a choice. Mm-hmm. Ikaw mamimili kung gusto mong gumamit ng kuryente o hindi. Mm-hmm. For example, when you at its best, no, because the WSM is what we call a developing product, yes. and it is not yet perfect. Mm-hmm. But when it becomes close to perfection, ang mangyayari doon, when you come home, for example, from the office, mm-hmm. and you go there and say, "Oy, kailangan ko mag-plancha." Mm-hmm. And then you look at the price, kasi naka-register doon ang presyo. "Oy, mahal pala ang kuryente ngayon. Mm-hmm. Huwag na lang ako mag-plancha." So mm-hmm. you can do that. Or else you say, "I want to watch TV," and mm-hmm. you know that your TV program cannot be aired later on. You want to watch it now. "Ah, manood na lang ako ng TV mm-hmm. kahit na mahal." So that is essentially what the WSM tries to do. Mm-hmm. Enable us to have a choice kung kailangan natin and at what price we are going to pay. Mm-hmm. So that's the end. Kaya lang, the problem is that, as they say, WSM selling electricity is not like selling litron manok, for example, na mm-hmm. i-display mo lang doon, pipili ang mga tao.
Yes.
A lot of rules have to be established. A lot of programs have to be set up in order to ensure that the price that will be charged by the generators is exactly the price that is desired by the consumers. Mm-hmm. Yun ang Juana siya. Given that, coming from the electric power industry, the WSM is a beautiful thing.
Yes.
Electricity spot market is a beautiful thing because prior to the WSM, ang presyo ng kuryente is determined by the electric the Electricity Regulatory Commission or Energy, sila ang nagdedetermine doon. And mm-hmm. most of the time, it is either very low or very high. Mm-hmm. Kung very low, gan siya ang mga generating company. Mm-hmm. Kung very high, sad, gan siya ang mga consumers. Mm-hmm. So that is the intent of the WSM, to put up a market so that the price will be exactly what the consumer desire and what the generators need. So mm-hmm. that's how is it done. But as I said, it's really complicated to set it up. Kaya lang, it's good to do. So, the WSM started in Luzon in 2006.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? And then in 2010, it was extended to the Visayas. Hindi naumpisahan agad sa Visayas because the interconnection between Visayas and Luzon were not adequate.
Yes,
kulang pa yan eh.
That's
kulang.
True.
Kulang yan na kwan. So, 2010.
Mm.
It was supposed to be extended to Mindanao in 2011.
Mm-hmm.
2011, dahil by that time we were expecting na makumpleto na. What is required for the WSM to be extended to Mindanao is makumpleto yung interconnection between Visayas and Mindanao, what we call a high voltage direct current interconnection. Mm-hmm. and the NGCP or the Transco, National Transmission Company, which is in charge of transmission, were saying that we will complete that in 2011. That was way back pa, mm-hmm. nung binubuo pa yung WSM, so we were anticipating that na one.
Mm-hmm.
When the NGCP came in later on, they said na hindi pwede sa 2011, sa 2017 na
uh-huh.
Pwede.
Mm-hmm.
Pero hanggang ngayon, wala. Ang natatapos lang ng NGCP is the study of that transmission. So wala pang transmission connection. Because wala pang transmission connection, hindi natin ma-extend yung kwan. It's not technically possible to operate mm-hmm. to extend the WSM into Mindanao
mm-hmm.
Until that's completed. Mm-hmm. We don't know now how long it's to be completed. They are saying again that it will be 2020. Whatever, when it is completed, it is good to extend the WSM to Mindanao because as we said, yun ang talagang tangka niya.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so when it is possible to extend it already because the connection is completed, then it will be good to be brought here.
Mm-hmm.
But right now, hindi po pwede yung WSM dito sa Mindanao because there is no interconnection. So we come to the question. While it is really beneficial,
mm-hmm.
and for the first years of it, because the question here is, has it been beneficial
to Luzon
and Visayas?
Yes.
And I would say that it has been beneficial up to 2011 2011, mm-hmm. up to 2011, kasi talagang makita mo sa kanyang presyo. The way of saying is whether it's beneficial, tignan mo lang yung presyo. Mm-hmm. If the presyo is talagang, because we engineers know how to approximate, yes, kung anong dapat na presyo ng kuryente noon. And if you see in the market na ganun siya, mm-hmm. Okay, you'll say okay. So we've been observing that, and up to 2011, ganun siya. But after 2011, wala na. It's either going very low or very high. Whatever, if it goes very low, ganun siya ang mga generating company lagi. Mm-hmm. When, if it goes very high, ganun siya sa mga konsumante. Mm-hmm. But that is what is happening. So on the question of has it been beneficial, we will have to let the question be answered by the people in Luzon. Mm-hmm. So I'm quoting now what the ARC has said, what the DOE has said, mm-hmm. what the Maralco has said, and what consumer groups have said about the wisdom as it is now. Mm-hmm. On the part of the ARC, ganitong sabi nila, after the 2013 price spikes, no, mm-hmm. natawag sa Luzon, mm-hmm. the ARC intervened into the operation of the wisdom in order to protect the consumers.
Yes.
Ganun ang kwantado. Their intervention is by setting a cap. Talagang binagyan nila ang level kung how much you are going to bid, mm-hmm. both during times of shortage and during times of shortage. On the part of the ARC kasi, it will not intervene into the wisdom for so long as it is operating properly. Mm-hmm. But when it misoperates and works to the prejudice of the consumers, they intervene. Mm-hmm. So as far as the ARC is concerned, wala. We have to intervene into the wisdom, operation of the wisdom, because it is not being beneficial to the consumers at the moment.
Okay.
And what I would say about that is that it is not beneficial only because of the mismanagement, mm-hmm. of the wisdom on the part of the PEMC. Mm-hmm. PEMC kasi ang market administrator yan. Eh. Mm. So I'm saying that hindi beneficial lang ngayon dahil mismanagement, but if you manage it correctly, it will be beneficial, and it will be beneficial to be extended to Mindanao when the time is right to extend it. So that's the main thing I would like to say about the question, has it been beneficial? Mm. Yes, it is. It should be beneficial. It is not beneficial now because of mismanagement, and the ARC has to intervene, and the DOE has to intervene into their operations, and all of the consumers in Luzon are complaining because of the price spikes. Ganun na yan. But that is only temporary. There will come a time when it will be, and hopefully before it gets extended into Mindanao, it will still be beneficial.
Okay.
So that is what I would say.
Engineer David, ito lang po. Engineer Dave, Sir Dave, ito. Ang sinasabi mo po, 2006, nag-operate po ang ating WESM in Luzon.
Luzon, right.
And you were saying that at that time, it was beneficial until the spike.
Until the price spikes in 2013.
Until the prices, the power
actually,
prices
until 2011.
Spikes. Yes. Mm-hmm. So, ibig sabihin po, mga kabrigada, maganda sana ang kanyang pamalakad starting 2006 hanggang po na-feel naman po natin, nakita natin sa TV na there was really a spike in the power rates in Luzon. So, nag-intervene po ang ARC. So, na-explain na po yan ni Sir David. Pero Sir David, ang sinasabi mo po kasi is, hindi po natin ma-implement or establish ang WESM sa Mindanao kasi nga may kakulangan on the part of the transmission network, ang NGCP na dating Transco po, na mag-put up doon sa tinatawag nilang high voltage transmission line.
So, yes,
high
voltage.
Kasi nandito po ako sa National Power Visayas, nandito na ako sa National Power Cebu, I mean, General Santos, all these years, hindi pa talaga ma-install yung tinatawag nilang kable na yan, connecting Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao, or Visayas to Mindanao. So, hindi po talaga, sa paningin nyo, ay hindi pwedeng i-implement ang WESM hanggang makonect tayo sa Visayas. Are you saying that?
Definitely, because it is, ang WESM kasi, it will allow, the Philippine WESM, it will allow people in Mindanao to buy generating from Visayas and Luzon, and the other way around. Mm-hmm. Kung saan ang mura, doon ka bibili.
That's right.
And in order to do that, the grids have to be interconnected.
Agree.
Yun ang kwanyon. That's the necessary requirement, mm-hmm. for a wisdom to be functional in Mindanao. Mm-hmm. But what the DOE are saying right now is that kahit na walang interconnection, Maglagayat na lang tayo ng wisdom dito sa Mindanao. And I would say that is a fake wisdom dahil the law does not allow that. The law is very, very specific that there is only one Philippine wisdom and it will be extended to the different islands as soon as there is an interconnection. So yun ang, so I'm saying that pagka natapos yan ng interconnection, we should all support the establishment of the wisdom. But hanggang wala yung interconnection na yan, no way.
No way. I-clarify ko lang mga kabrigada, meron pa akong konting kaalaman sa power industry. Ganito po yon. Ang Luzon po, sila ay tinatawag na Luzon Grid. Meron silang sariling mga power plants dyan. Right. They compose the Luzon Grid. Right. Ang Visayas naman po, may mga sariling mga planta dyan, tinatawag silang Visayas Grid. Tayo naman dito sa Mindanao, tinatawag tayong Mindanao Grid. Ngayon po, in the many years that passed, meron po talagang napakalaking transmission line dyan na nagko-connect ng ating Luzon and Visayas na tinatawag lang, nasa taas po yan eh, hindi po yan underground. Hindi po siya underground na kable na dumadaan ng kuryente, kundi nasa taas po na nagko-connect ng Luzon at Visayas na doon po pumapasok ang kuryente. Kaya nga po, kung maputol yung linya na yan at kung may kulang sa Visayas, eh talagang mag-brown out sila. Kasi kung continuous ang supply ng or ang operation ng linya na yan, na high voltage na linya na yan, eh kung walang may kakulangan ng Visayas, bibili po ng kuryente ang mga taga-Visayas. Hindi po ang mga consumers ha, ang mga generating companies po ang bibili ng kuryente galing po doon sa Luzon at papasok po ito sa Visayas via that high voltage transmission line. Ngayon ang sinasabi ni Sir David na hindi po mapunta sa atin kung may kukulangan ang Mindanao, hindi po mapunta ang kuryente galing Luzon ng Visayas. Kung wala yung sinasabing high voltage transmission line na mag-connect sa atin, yun ang tinatawag na interconnection of all the grids.
Right.
Okay.
Thank you very much,
Sir Dave. So ngayon po, Sir Dave, sinasabi mo na kung mag-put up tayo ng WESM sa Mindanao, ay hindi po pwedeng matawag ito na legitimate or genuine kasi nga po, ang supply galing lang sa Mindanao, hindi po ba?
Right.
Hindi magagaling sa ibang lugar kung may kukulangan.
It's not so much that. Ang nakakakuha doon is that kailangan ng WESM kung maraming generating companies.
Yes.
Okay, marami.
Uh-huh.
And when we say marami, in Luzon for example, there are 31 generating companies that supply the consumer. So
yes,
pwede sila mag-compete. But if there are only very few generating companies, nagkukulyod ang mga yan, tawag nila eh. Collusion is simply, nagsabot-sabot bitaw sila sa presyo. Kaya mayroon sila, so pwede sila magsabot sa presyo. So mauna yung rason nga, dili pwede ibutang ang WESM din sa Mindanao, nga dili connected. Kaya unobra man ang atong generating companies. Okay, there are only six and those six have been proven in Luzon, okay, to be colluding. So kung din sa Mindanao, magyapong buhato nila. You collude by either agreeing on the price that you will charge. Pwede man sila magsabot. Kaya unum-unum raman. Pilarag ko'y pag-meet and then say that ikaw mag-charge ka o ingon ene. Kaya ang presyo manggot sa WESM, usara man. Usara na siya. So that is what they do. They will stage their prices so that they higher price. Or else what they will do is that withhold nila. They will refrain, which you have been doing in Luzon, okay? That's why I'm saying that if you put up a WESM nga wala interconnection, mo na buhatong gihapon din eh sa Mindanao. So what they will do is withhold capacity so that only the expensive power plants will be able to supply. So hydro pa nang litan. Hydro, barato man na siya diha. Pero kung doon ay WESM, pwede ang pisang magsulti nga, ay hadi saan ako na i-dispatchar. And if i-dispatchar, ang mga mahal nga kwan ang ma-dispatch. So anong kwan na siya. So that's essentially the reason why you do not do it without the interconnection because there are very few generating companies in Mindanao.
So that's the wisdom.
That's
so mga kabrigada, yung sinasabi po ni Engineer Dave or Mr. Dave na ang wisdom po doon is paano tayo mag-put up ng WESM sa Mindanao kung napakaliit lang po ang ating players or ang ating mga generating companies or GenCos. So I move forward to my question, although na-answer mo na Sir Dave, pero sige lang, gusto ko pa rin marinig. Kasi yung sinasabi, kasi si Sir Dave po mga kabrigada ay talagang advocate po siya. He has been an advocate of the power industry's reforms. And gusto ko po yan kasi ako naman po eh 20 years po sa power industry, serving po mga limang kumpanya po sa power. So naiintindihan ko po yung kanyang advokasya. So ngayon po, Sir David, ang sinasabi mo po sa iyong mga ginagawang mga articles na pina-forward po niya sa ating mga congressmen, senators at mga players, no? Sinasabi kasi niya ay ang pag-put up po ng proposed Mindanao WESM or merkado ng bintahan ng kuryente is illegal, violative of the Electric Power Industry Reform Act of 2001, yung IPIRA po, and will be economically disastrous for Mindanao. Bakit mo po nasabi yun? At bakit ikaw po ay talagang against it? Meron ba pong alternative kung hindi Mindanaoism?
Right. Very good again that is raised. Economic disaster, I'm just using a big word for something, but you can explain that phenomena. Pananglitan again, going back to lechon manok. Kung tulurang, upat ang supply of lechon manok din sa General Santos, daghan man kita nga magusto og lechon manok, the other part, magsabot-sabot silang, baligyan na lang nato ng 500 pesos. On another part, we have no choice. Kay unumra man na siya sila diha. That is the situation that is going to happen in Mindanao. If you have a wisdom here, and there are only 6 generators, sa akong pagtanaw, the minimum number of generating companies that should offer is 20 generating companies.
Wow.
Okay, nga equal sizes na siya diha. Uh-huh. Ayan pa sila, pwede mag-compute nga dili magkulyod.
Okay.
Or even if they withhold power, dili sila influence the price because there are
many
of them.
Yes.
Anang na diha. So if you have very few, mao na mahitabo kanang mga gabalig nga lechon manok, magsabot lang sila nga magcharge lang tag 500 pesos, and that is how they are going to do it. So economic disaster na. Look, I have run through all of the numbers of we call this economic dispatch kasi anang pag-dispatcher.
Yes.
Sa pag-sulti sa generator, okay, pwede ka na mag-operate, ikaw na generator to mag-operate, economic dispatch that is done, it is being done right now in Mindanao, okay, dispatch by the NGCP.
Yes.
And they dispatch it what we call least cost economic dispatch.
Okay.
Anang na, meaning that you dispatch the least cost dispatch price first. Pero kung naiwisim, ang mahitabuan na siya diha, highest bid dispatch, okay? Highest bid dispatch, meaning that the highest price will be the price for all of the electricity which is dispatched at the time.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So, given that, anyway, okay, karon, it's being dispatched by the NGCP. What is going to happen if it is dispatched in a wisdom which is characterized by only very few generating companies? What is going to happen in this? And I am saying this is going to happen, no, because when magundi siya, these are all programmed, okay? These are all programmed, the price determination, maghimo kang program, magdetermine
ang nature. Yeah, scientific.
Oh, so you can simulate it even if there is no wisdom there. And my simulation shows that if the wisdom is, a wisdom type of pricing is placed in Mindanao, the cost, ang bayaran sa konsumante bitaw in 1 year, 15 billion pesos additional.
Wow.
15 billion, 1.5 billion. Oh, that's billion, okay? Billion because it's simply, dako man kayong kurente nga gaikwan na siya diha. Unya, the increase in price is 1 peso and 40 centavos, actually, sa karon, 4.20 man ta. 4.20 pesos ang average price nato siya diha. Ibutang di mo ang wisdom or price determination methodology sa wisdom, musaka ng presyo sa 5.60. 5.60 is something like 1.20 pesos per kilowatt hour.
Okay.
That amount, considering the total that we are consuming, 15 billion ang i-contribute nato. So what I'm saying is that it is economically disastrous because it results in transferring money from us consumers to the power generating companies. Nga, di man kayo necessary because we are doing it now.
That's right.
And that is where the next question you brought out came. What is the alternative doing this? What we need to do simply, kaya ang problema manggut sa walay sa in Mindanao power sa karon, over what we call over capacity ang contract sa mga
distribution utilities,
electric cooperatives. Nag-contract sila og sobra sa ilahang gikinahanglan. So problema karon na unsa man ka nato kay do na man po uban nga kulang ang iyahang gi-contract. So what you need to do is obviously transfer the over contracts to the uncontracted, and people up there are saying that in order to do that, magtaot ang wisdom. Pero you do not need a wisdom in order to do that. You just agree on rules that will be implemented by the NGCP, and then siya na ang magkuhan nga karon nga time sobra man ko unya kato dito kulang palihog ibalhin ang akong supply dito sa kulang. So that is what I have asked actually the electric cooperative to do. Come up with the rules that will enable you to get rid of your over contract to those who are under contracted. And if you come out with the rules, then happy na tatanan. You do not have to, ang akong kwan maguda ng wisdom is sledgehammer solution to something, to a problem which can be by just tapping, by tapping it. So that's it actually. All we need to do is get the electric cooperative to establish the rules under which they can share their overcapacity with those who are under capacity. Then ask the NGCP to implement those type. Mahimong dispatching man na siya dayon. Dispatching, so in their dispatching, dispatch na gihapon, the same way they are doing. Pero sa allocation karon, ako lang man siya dito. Normally, you would penalize him. But now, with sobra sa kwan, agibalhin man niya din eh. So okay ra. So it's that one. So there is a solution that can address what we perceive as a problem. Pero kini nga problema, buhat-buhat lang din sa mga electric cooperatives. I'm sorry to say this, but the electric cooperatives have not been managing very well their operations. That's why this problem is. But as I said, you electric cooperatives can solve it on your own.
Yes.
On your own. So, ingon na.
Sir, ito lang. You were saying about over-contract. Ito kasi mga kabrigada, yung ating mga electric co-ops po, for example, Socotec 1, Socotec 2, Hotelco, Co-Light, yung mga cooperatives po all over our area nga malapit sa General Santos City po. Meron po yan silang mga kontrata po sa mga generating companies. Example lang para maintindihan niyo po. For example, ang ating Socoteco 2, meron po yan siyang kontrata sa Sarangani Energy Corporation na kumukuha po siya ng kuryente doon na meron talaga silang kontrata pinirmahan na kukuha tayo doon ng certain megawatts sa kanila. So, ibig sabihin doon na bilateral contract yon na kung may... Kukunin natin yon, diretso sa atin yung kontra, yung power na yon, diretso sa Socoteco 2. Ngayon, meron din kontrata ang Socoteco 2 sa iba pang mga power companies or generating companies. Para hindi po kayo malito, independent power producers or GenCos, generating companies. Okay, yun ha. Similar yun, IPPs and GenCos, para hindi kayo malito. Ngayon, yung ating Socoteco 2 ay meron din kontrata sa ibang mga power generating companies or GenCos. Ngayon, Sir David, gusto ko lang i-clear natin sa mga kabrigada natin, bakit may tinatawag tayong over-contract?
Over-contract as... It should not be done, really. Alam mo, that should never happen.
Okay.
I have been doing contracts in Sipalco for 20 years or more, and I always say to it that the contracts we have are exactly what we need. You can ima-project man mo ang imong mga requirements through the years, so you should contract only up to that capacity. An over-contract is simply, pananglitan sa kutay ko to, magkinanglan siya 100 megawatts nga power, o niya, nag-contract siya og total of 120, which it had, I think. I have not seen Socoteco 2, but I know for sure that 16 out of the 27 electric cooperatives in Mindanao have over-contracted. Anang na siya. So, 100 lang imong kinanglan, 120 ang imong i-contract, di.
May sobra.
Sobra. Ang mahitong mong gudin siya, di ha, most of these contracts are actually illegal, ha? Illegal, because they are natawag nila nga take or pay. Take or pay provision, which means that even if you do not consume what you contracted, you will pay for it. Una, asa man di ay pabayaran sa electric co-op ang ilahang take or pay, di sa consumers. Meaning that because of the over-contract, we consumers will be forced to pay for what we did not consume because of the over-contract. Kita hanggang alaot sa ilahang pag-over-contract. That's why the ECs are careless about over-contracting because they know that they are not going to pay for it. Man, ipasa man nila dito sa kwana siya. So, muna ay kadautan na ng over-contract, okay? 100 ang ilahang atong requirements, total requirements natin sa consumers. Nag-contract sila sa 120 megawatts. So, those 20 megawatts, even if we cannot consume, bayaran gihapon na ito. So, mauna ay kadautan na ng over-contract. That's the problem that will be solved. But you do not need to place a wisdom lagi to solve it. Kaya it only requires Sabot-sabot lang nining mga electric cooperatives.
Okay. Sir, before po ako magbigay ng response or feed or mga akin pong question in relation to the explain ni Engineer Dave po, ay basahin ko po itong mensahe ng ating favorite texter, ha? Si Sir Richard Pernian, sabi po niya, bright brain po yan si Engineer David. Oh, sir, meron ka ng fan. Si Sir Pernia, bright brain ka po daw. Okay, sir, ito lang po. Ang sinasabi kasi ng ating mga electric cooperatives na kailangan po silang mag-project. So, for example, yung sinasabi po niyo, example na ito mga brigada, hindi ito yung totoong actual figure. So, for example, sasabihin po nila na kahit na 100 megawatts yung requirement namin, kailangan namin ng magdagdag ng 20 megawatts para po in case of emergency, meron pa rin pa kaming pagkukunan ng kuryente.
Of course, you need that. But yung kwan kasi, for emergency purposes, emergency purposes, you do not contract for electricity because all of those are normally taken. Nagiging problema lang in the past because yun na nga, kulang tayo ng capacity. Mm-hmm. But at the moment, it is the job of the NGCP to ensure that at any time, there is adequate capacity that will take care of emergencies.
Okay.
Meron yan palagi. Mm-hmm. So, you, as I said, there's something wrong with the management of the electric cooperatives because for emergency requirements, you do not over-contract for that purpose because it's wrong. Mm-hmm. It's wrong to do that. And if you're reasoning that way, mali, I will have to say, I tell you, mali yan. As I said, emergencies are being taken care of. And then on the other hand, a lot of these electricities have already installed diesel generating plants, okay?
That's true.
That is for the purpose
of emergency.
Of being using during emergencies. Yun ang kwanon. So, if you are telling me, electric co-op, pagkatapos sasabihin mo sa akin na we will increase this one because we need it for emergency, I'm saying that you are stupid. Yun talaga ang gana.
So, ibig sabihin, sir, ang forecast na basis po ng kanilang computation may not be accurate because they're saying it's a forecast.
Yeah.
Or maybe they want to be on the safe side all the time.
We are safe all the time about forecasting. Mm-hmm. Ang problema mo lang kasi yung mga sudden may malaking company na coming in there. It does not take hindi naman instantly na kailangan yan eh. 3 years pa yan bago. So you can always plan forward for the requirements of that company. So there is no excuse really for contracting beyond your projected requirements. If in the first place, your projected requirements are correct. And madali lang yung pag-project. As I said, the only thing that you have to take care of are the big ones. And this will give you appropriate notice. Mm-hmm. Walang malaking company na suddenly sabing, kailangan namin ng 10 megawatts bukas. They will not do that. They will say that we will need 10 megawatts in
the next
3 years' time. So you have time to plan for that. Yung mga residential at saka small commercial, it's very easy to project that. Straight line projection lang yan eh. Mm-hmm. You just say 5% ang growth, historical growth natin. So 5%. So you contract for that. Yun ang kwan. There is no excuse really for over-contracts. I'm telling you. In fact, you could sue your utility for incompetence for over-contracting. Ganyan ako. That's why I'm telling the electric cooperative, you better solve that problem. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, I will go down to your consumers and get them to solve the problem for you.
That's
And we are doing that in any number of cases now where the electric co-op really made a mistake, like contracting without going through public bidding.
That's right.
That's a no-no. Mm-hmm. Okay? So, right now, in Malaybalay, the consumers there are going to show their
electric
co-ops for doing that. So ganun ang kwan noon. So all electric co-ops, you correct the errors of the past before the consumers get notice of this and file charges against you instead. That's what I'm telling the electric cooperative.
I like that. Let's correct the error of the past. Pero mga kabrigada, mag-break pa muna tayo kasi babalik pa tayo sa mainit pa pong talakayan with Engineer Dave. We'll be back!
Gagawang Pilipino. Natural na masipag. natural na matiyaga. Ang Power Cells Herbal Capsule ay sumasaludo sa bawat manggagawang Pilipino.
Sa dugeng panahon, nakitagilin na sa mga haplas gaway klarong epekto. Biyay na alandan! Kay Aniana, ang haplas niya natural o garantisadong epektibo. Power Cells Liniment!
Power Cells Liniment!
Ang haplas niya mo impas sa panaul, paghubad sa joints o arthritis, allergy o katul sa panika, buhi o panuhot, o daghan pa!
Power Cells Liniment!
Power Cells Liniment! Mabalit sa butika, dool sa inyong lugar!
Power Cells Liniment!
Sakit sa lawas, impas!
Ma, matagal pa ba si Kuya?
Malapit na anak!
Uy, Gio!
Mga anak, hinanda ako paborito nyo.
Uy, Zoya Choco!
Sustansya ra!
Sharing favorites, sharing love with Zoya Choco.
Ayan po mga kabrigada, welcome back. Ang ating pong topic sa mga ngayon lang po nag-switch on or ngayon lang po nanood sa kanilang mga television sets. Ang ating topic po sa Insights this morning is the Mindanao Wholesale Electricity Spot Market or WASM. Will it benefit Mindanao or not? And ang ating guest po ay si Engineer David Tauli po, si Sir Dave. O ngayon Sir Dave, ang sinasabi mo po kanina ay meron pong alternative ang sinatawag na Mindanao WASM, which is being done right now. So kung gagawin po natin yung sinasabi po ni Sir David na alternative, ay hindi na po tayo kailangan ng WASM. Ano nga ulit yung pangalan yung iyong alternative, Sir Dave? Economic dispatch.
Least cost economic dispatch. Under the law kasi, the electric cooperative distribution utility companies are always required to procure their power supply requirements for their customers at least cost. Very clear yan sa
pinakabarato.
Kung unsay pinakabarato nga available mo, ipalitin nimo. And in order to do that, you are always required to go through public bidding. Kaya ano sa pagkahibulot nga barato ni if you do not go through public bidding? It's only by going through public bidding will people tell you, ang akong presyo mo, money siya. Okay, so
that's mga kabrigada, gusto ko lang iklaro po. Yung sinasabi po na competitive public bidding, dapat po alam natin yan lahat. Yun pong mga consumers po ng iba't ibang cooperatives po na naaabot po ng ating show ngayon or talakayan, bantayan nyo po yung mga co-op nyo. Dapat po yung mga co-op nyo ay hindi lang po papasok ng kontrata sa isang power generating company or GenCo na hindi dumaan sa competitive bidding. Ibig sabihin, dapat meron pong mag-bid dyan na iba't ibang generating companies at yung pinaka-least po, pinakamurang benta ng kuryente, yun po ang kukunin ng ating electric co-op. Kaya kung ang ating mga co-op po ay hindi nagsasagawa po ng competitive public bidding, ay magsalita na po tayo. Kasi kailangan po marinig nila na tayo ay gusto po ng pamaraan na fair po na malalaman kung sino yung nagbibigay ng pinakamurang offer ng electric cost or power rates sa ating co-op na eventually babayaran natin sa pamamagitan ng paggamit natin ng elektrisidad sa ating mga bahay-bahay. O yan po, mga kabrigada, yung sinasabi po ni Engineer Dave po na NGCP naman, ito po yung National Grid Corporation of the Philippines na dating National Transmission Corporation. Ito naman yung tinatawag na transmission network. Lahat po ng kuryente na galing po sa iba't ibang power plants ay dumadaan po sa NGCP kasi sila po ang operator ng supply ng kuryente. So dumadaan po sa kanilang substations yung kuryente at dinidispatcha po nila sa mga electric co-op. So yun ang sinasabi ni Sir Dave ng NGCP po, nakakaalam kung ano ang mga planta o anong panahon na may kakulangan ng kuryente at nagsasabi po sila sa mga electric co-op. Tama po ba, Sir Dave?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Ito, Sir Dave, yung ating next question. Mga kabrigada, talagang napakainit po pag kuryente kasi nga kuryente, hindi ba? Puno ng power. Okay, Sir Dave, ang sinasabi mo po, Ang sinasabi kasi po ng ating ERC at saka yung batas, dapat po na ang WESM ay mag-i-encourage ng competition,
yes,
sa generation sector, mm-hmm, promoting transparency and accurate information of electricity costs, mm-hmm, and providing signals for investment opportunities. Sa tingin mo ba, hindi ito mangyayari sa Mindanao kung may WESM?
Again, it cannot be done, it can be done only if the interconnection is there.
Okay, interconnection.
If the interconnection is there, mangyayari lahat yan. Mm-hmm. But sa proposal kasi nila, they are placing in a way na wala pang interconnection.
Okay.
It will not happen.
Yes.
It will not happen na ganun kwan. And also, it will not happen unless the WESM is properly managed.
Yes.
So I'm saying that in addition to that not happening in WESM in Mindanao, simply because there is an interconnection, it is not happening now in Luzon, mm-hmm, because of the mismanagement of the electricity market. Mm-hmm. Right now, they are saying, for example, that the WESM will induce competition. Mm-hmm. Okay, yan. Pero sa Luzon, dapat ganun ang kwan, wala eh, nagkukulyod. That is why there are price spikes in December 2016, for example, the Meralco had to charge their consumers an additional of 4 pesos, 4 pesos and 15 centavos, simply because of the price spikes in the WESM.
Mm.
4 pesos siya. Meaning kung if you are a residential customer, 11 ang binabayaran mo normally, nagiging 15 na yan.
Yes.
And that is a consequence, again, of mismanagement on the part of the administrator, PEMC na kwanaan. Because hindi mangyayari na tataas ng ganun kakwan or that long a time. It can happen only because, yun na nga, itong mga generating companies, you know, generating companies, you are in there to make money, okay? Mm. And fine, actually here in the Philippines, the best way of making money right now, among those who have a lot of money, is to invest in power sector.
That's right.
Pero legitimate kwan lang yun. Sa legitimate profits na, okay ka na. Mm. You do not have to cool you, you do not have to force a price increase. In order to do that, but what is happening in Luzon is that the generating companies are not contented with the money that they are getting. So yun ang Juan, the DOE has already identified 11 generating companies na nagkulyod noong
situation na yon
during that price spikes, and that is the reason why Petrosa, because yun na nga, nagsabot-sabot mangod sila sa presyo. Ang pagkita mo ato dito pananglitan, TMO, tawag nila nga thermomobile generating plant, it's a diesel generating plant. Ang iyang normal nga presyo is 8 pesos and 62 centavos, which it is selling to Meralco.
Mm.
Pero during the time na doon ay panahon sa social, gisaka nila ang presyo to 62 pesos per kilowatt hour.
Wow.
From 8 to 62 pesos per kilowatt hour. Kunya, there is only one price in the WESM.
Uh-huh.
So tanan nga presyo anang oras, 62.
Oh my goodness.
Okay? So mauna siya. It can happen only because of pollution. Kwa na siya diha. So mauna, that is what we would like to prevent here in Mindanao until that's bound to happen. Ang inevitable result bang guna na siya diha, musa ka nga itong bayro nun. As I said, normally right now, considering everything, nata sa mga 11 pesos per kilowatt hour.
Mm-hmm.
All in na siya, distribution cost, transmission, og generation.
Mm-hmm.
But if you put in the WESM, madugang ang iyong presyo, og peso per kilowatt hour or more actually.
Mm-hmm.
What is going to happen is that, you know, investors outside there who are interested in coming to Mindanao, di na hinuon mo sila. Well, kay mahal man ang kurente.
Mm.
So what they are saying that it will induce investment is it will not happen unless the WESM again is properly operational.
Mm-hmm.
Because with the WESM that is operating correctly, sigurado man nga ang i-bid sa mga generating companies, their true costs. They will be their true costs. It will not happen nga. Nakikwani mo nga, klaro na sa ato nga at 60. Wanya, magbidino ng 62 pesos.
That's right, that's right.
So that's first, taposon nito ang air connection. Second, you reform the administration of the WESM. If that happens, all of the things that they are saying will happen.
That's right.
Naman air condition.
That's right. Mga kabrigada, yun ulit, sasabihin ko po, i-emphasize ko po na ang WESM po sa Mindanao ay kailangan po na ma-interconnected po ang buong Philippine grid,
right,
okay?
Right.
I-connect po ang Luzon to Visayas grid, i-connect po ang Visayas grid to Mindanao grid. We will have one Philippine WESM para po maging effective at ma-achieve po yung mga goals ng isang WESM. Pero ito, Engineer Dave, Sir Dave, may sinasabi mo kasi kanina yung PEMC, hindi ba?
PEMC, right. Yes. Philippine Electricity Market
yes.
Corporation.
Okay. I-emphasize natin mga kabrigada, yung operator po ng WESM is the?
PEMC.
Yes, baka, kasi baka malito kayo. Yung sinatawag nating WESM or Merkado ng Bintahan ng Kuryente, meron po yung operator, yung sinasabi po ni Sir David na Philippine
Electricity Management Corporation.
So sila po yung manager. Right. Right. Sila po yung right. nagmamanage ng WESM sa Luzon and Visayas. Kasi wala pa rito, hindi pa nila mamamanage ang Mindanao. At dagdag ko lang po, Sir Dave, hindi po ba kahit walang WESM sa Mindanao, ang dami naman nating investors? Whether we have the WESM in Mindanao or not, people are coming to Mindanao to invest.
Yes, because the rates are low
yes,
right now.
Exactly.
That is why we have to ensure that it remains low.
That's right.
Pero pagka naglagay ka ng WESM dito na walang interconnection, tataas yung presyo.
Yes,
that is why we have to exert all effort to ensure yun na yun naman talagang target eh. Keep, because we are lower by 1 peso than Visayas and Luzon.
Mm-hmm.
We have to maintain that competitive advantage in order to ensure that all of those investors will continue to come.
Yes.
Yun ang pinaka bottom line, we might
That's
call
right.
it, of all of this hula-bulo about the
WESM.
The WESM here na wala yeah. pa naman.
Tama yung mga kabrigada, sabi ni Engineer Dave po, na ang ating kuryente po sa Mindanao ay talagang very low ang ating power rates. Tayo po, comparing to Visayas and Luzon, we are enjoying the least power rates among regions. So ibig sabihin, dahil napakababa po ng ating kuryente po na binabayaran ng mga negosyante at mga like us, mga ordinary citizens, ay talagang dito pupunta yung mga investors kasi
right.
ang kanilang
right.
investment is pag-project nila ng kanilang expenses, low ang kanilang expense on power.
Right.
And that is a
right.
very expensive material for production, hindi po ba, Sir David?
Yeah.
Kaya,
That is being threatened right now because the reason for the low rates in Mindanao is because of the Agos and Pulangi hydroelectric power plants.
Mm-hmm.
Piso lang ito eh.
Mm-hmm.
Piso lang ang generation ng hydroelectric power plants. But now, people in somewhere out there are saying, dapat i-privatize mo yung Agos Pulangi.
Hindi dapat.
If that happens,
wala
the peso
na.
Rate will become 5 pesos. Wala, nawawala naman ang ating competitive advantage. That's the whole point in all of these things. If those who are proposing anything for power, the only question that we ask them, is that going to ensure that the rates remain low?
Mm-hmm.
If it is going to ensure that the rates remain low, okay, go ahead and do it.
I don't think so. Kasi mga kabrigada, yung ating Pulangi at Agus Hydroelectric Power Plants po, yan talaga ang main source ng power supply dito sa Mindanao. Kaya tayo po ay nag-enjoy ng low power rates.
Right.
Eh because hydroelectric power plants po ang major component ng ating electricity.
Yes.
Yung protection po na hindi yan ma-privatize or hindi yan ma-sold to private companies ay dahil po sa protection na naka-tuck-in po sa IPIRA, hindi po ba?
Yes.
So kung yung provision na yan po ay malabid po ng ating mga congressman at senator na ma-open po yan, ma-amend, ay talagang ma-privatize yan. Kaya tayo sa Mindanao, hindi tayo papayag dyan upang hindi maging privatized yung ating mga hydropower plants dyan na pag-aari ng gobyerno at hindi aakyat yung power rates when it becomes private. Ito po, Sir David, ang last question ko kasi ito is very controversial issue din. Kasi mga kabrigada, dapat po nating malaman kung ano yung ibang mga technical words na ginagamit ng power industry. Meron po silang tinatawag na Retail Competition Open Access or RCOA. Okay? So, although very technical ito, Sir David, please explain to us naman in layman's language, bakit mo nasabi na yung DOE and ERC officials ay wala pong pagkakaintindi o hindi nila naintindihan kung ano ang provisions ng IPIRA about the Retail Competition Open Access or RCOA?
Right. Actually, that's a charitable way of putting the actions of explaining the actions of the ERC and the DOE right now and the RCOA. Ang retail access kasi, it's very simple. Do not be confused by the very long-term RCOA.
Yes.
What this is simply saying is that sa ngayon, ang distribution companies lang ang pwede nakakabili sa generating plants.
Mm-hmm.
With retail competition, ang mismo consumers will be able to buy directly.
Wow.
Meaning that they can bypass their distribution
utilities,
companies, and then buy directly from the
generating
plants. Okay, mm-hmm. So yun ang and if it were implemented that way, if only they opened it up to that, okay na sana.
Mm-hmm.
Kaya lang, here comes the DOE, and here comes the DRC saying that lahat ng mga consumers dapat umalis sa kanilang mga distribution utility companies at bibili ng kanilang supply from
wow.
generating companies.
Mm-hmm.
The law does not say that.
Yes.
The law says only that all consumers should be able to access their the generators directly, but they can choose to remain with the distribution utility
right.
companies. Dahil gusto mong lilipat doon kung mas mura lang yung pinagbibili sa kwan. That's the only time that you would want to transfer. But in the case of the Philippines, right now, the in Luzon, the distribution utility companies are selling their power at prices lower than what is being requested by generating companies.
Mm-hmm.
So kung mangyari na ganun, you require all of them to leave their distribution companies and buy from the generating companies, maging mahal.
Mm-hmm.
Maging mahal ang bibilhin mo. Apart from which, it's not very reliable
mm-hmm.
when you buy your power directly from a generating company.
That's
because
right.
gamay raman ang imong magpalit
yes.
sa ilahaw niya. Anytime, they can say, ay, nanatang na mag-supply na ini. Anang kwa na siya. So, I am saying, in effect, that because in all other places noon, mm-hmm. naka namang retail company diha.
Mm-hmm.
Texas, all over USA, all over Europe, New Zealand,
mm-hmm.
Australia, naana may retail.
Mm-hmm.
Pero the condition for the retail is that libre ka nga mo palit.
Mm-hmm.
Dili kay imong biyaan ang imong distribution utility company.
Yes.
I'm not been required to that. You have only been allowed to buy directly from generating companies or their agents.
Mm-hmm.
Ganun ang kanon. So, yun ang mali ng ERC at saka DOE. They ginawa nilang mandatory instead of a market is always voluntary.
Yes.
That is precisely why it is a market because you can choose to buy from that market.
Yes.
Kung mandatory, hindi na market yan. But here you are, ERC, which is supposed to be protecting consumers' interests.
Mm-hmm.
That is their main thing.
Mm.
They are requiring, they are mandating that they will transfer to sa mga generating companies. So, correct ang consumers sa Luzon. They should nag-file sila ng temporary temporary restraining order to stop that one. And the case is now being heard. For sure, the ERC will be directed to restore the choice of the consumer to remain with their distribution utility companies. So, simple lang yung retail. Actually, they are trying to make it complicated up
yes.
there in order that, but it's simple. It says that with a retail competition, kita nga konsumante, pwede ta makapalit directly sa mga ahente, sa mga generating companies. But,
mm-hmm.
if we do not like to do that, pwede ta magpabilin gihapon nga magpalit sa atong distribution
mm-hmm.
utility company. So, that's how it is.
Mm-hmm.
Klaro ba na sa'yo mo?
Yes.
Oh, right.
Yes.
So
ibig sabihin, Engineer Dave, na in Luzon, they were being told by ERC na if you want to avail of the power supply of other generating companies, you leave your distribution
you
utility?
Leave. You are required.
Wow.
You are required. Ganun ang nakalagay sa kanilang, that's why they were sued.
Mm-hmm.
And correctly,
mm-hmm.
may TRO na, Juan. You stop that while we listen to your case. And then when the case is heard, market is always voluntary.
That's
you do
right.
not order anybody dito ka magpalit.
Yeah.
Dili na ng merkado because
correct.
The market precisely is that ako na magbuot kung magpalit ba ko diha o dinhi ba ko magpalit sa akong kapalitan niya ato. So, there is nothing complicated here.
Yes.
The issue is not complicated. It's simply that.
Mm-hmm.
You can reduce it to that terms.
Yes. Okay.
So,
sir, ito lang. Banggitin ko lang ulit ha, mga kabrigada. Wala pa pong WESM sa Mindanao. Pero meron na pong mga consultation meetings, Sir David. Marami na pong consultation meetings na ginagawa po ng ating DOE. Kasama na po ang family of the energy, kasi may tinatawag energy family eh. Yung lahat po ng mga opisina ng gobyerno na ang kanilang trabaho ay tungkol sa enerhiya, ay members po sila lahat sa energy family. So yung ating DOE po, ay naglalabi na po ng paggawa ng WESM sa Mindanao. Ano po ang iyong posisyon doon?
Ang
statement
right,
mo po doon?
What I would say is that because it is illegal, the DOA on their own and the PMC on their own will not really advocate this. Kay buluman sila ang nga business nga dili gyud ni siya mahitabo. So mangutan na ta, nganong gai kon man nila. And I will tell you this, no. A fisherman Mindanao will only benefit the generating companies. And I can tell you right now who are the generating companies who are supporting the establishment of the WASM. This is the Alcantara nga moy kwan ning kwan ang Abutis company in Davao and what was the third one San Miguel. San Miguel Corporation. So kana there are six generating companies, dominant generating companies in Mindanao. Mm-hmm. Those three are the ones who are advocating the WASM. And on the part of the DOA, they should have been the one to instruct them nga, dili na pwede kayo wala pa interconnection. Mm-hmm. Instead, here we see a DOA saying that we will establish WASM. Una, dili pa ni first time nga buhat nila actually.
Actually.
IMM, di ditangi with the IMM ni Adto nga kuha na siya. Diha, of course, we stop that. We stop the IMM, but they are now saying, gihunong na mo ng IMM, kaya nahimong critical man ng Mindanao. Why critical? No, they stopped it simply because we complained to the Congress, and the Congress commanded
listen
them to stop.
You. Right. Yeah, sir, explain natin ano yung IMM kasi hindi naintindihan ng ating mga kabrigada.
Oh, ang IMM is, again, pareha lang ng itang wisdom na promote karon pero ang tawag niya is Interim Mindanao Electricity Market.
Ah, okay.
Electricity market gihapon.
Market pa rin.
Electricity market. So yun ang what they did and we stopped that. And that is going what is going to happen with this new attempt to WASM. We'll go to Congress. And if the Congress doesn't stop it, we'll go to the Supreme Court. Klaro man na sa balaod. Okay? So that is what all of these efforts on the part of the DOE are actually useless things, which is why this program is very useful because it allows people to know what is really out there. Yun ang kwan, not only what the DOE is telling them. Kaya, let me tell you, I'm sorry to say this, but what the DOE and the PMC are doing about kwan are lies, bakak. Anong kwan, like competition. Tinuod man na siya o doon ay tinuod ng WASM, okay? But with an isolated WASM, wala. All of those are lies. So that's it. I'm not worried about all of their campaigns to do it because we will stop you either at the Congress or at the Supreme Court. Pero what is important is to inform the people properly about their kwan. Maura man na importante. That's supposed to be the job of the DOA. Why are they coming here and telling lies? Mauna akong punto lang din ha. That's why bisag unsay kalayon sa General Santos gikan sa Mindanao, Cagayan de Oro. Here I am. And that is only the purpose. Aron, mahibawaan ninyo kung unsay. What are the facts about the electric power industry?
Yes, last word mo, sir. Bago tayo mamaalam. Last word mo sa ating mga kabrigada. Invite them to this afternoon's forum.
the only point here is that we consumers need to be vigilant.
Yes, true.
Well, as pointed out by our host here, it's really complicated industry, but it's not that complicated. You just have to reduce it. Unya, ang konsumante yun, ang mismo mag-protect sa ilaha. Mama na problema nato din sa power industry because there are very, very few consumer groups in various places. So, if there is a last message, that organize yourself and watch all of these things because there is plenty of money being made in the electric power industry and that money is all coming from consumers. So kung dili mo magbantay, magbayad mo perting dakuha. It's not necessary. So that's it. Study the electric power industry, organize yourself in order to ensure that your electric cooperatives, particularly electric cooperatives ang inyong atbangon. Ayaw na mong atbang sa ERC, ayaw na mong atbang nini. Electric cooperatives lang. Watch what they are doing because none of these things would happen if the electric cooperatives were doing their job, okay? They will not be able to do that. Walay pwede ma-impose nila kung tarong lang ang pagkadagan sa electric cooperatives. So how can we do that? Vigilant consumer groups.
That's right, mga kabrigada. Thank you po, Sir David, for your presence and for giving us the 101 on WASM and the electric power industry. Mga kabrigada, bago po ako magbigay na aking extra, I'd like to say good morning po sa ating mga viewers sa Brigada Pharmacy in Bula. Yes, thank you very much for watching us and for listening to us. And of course, to Mommy Rose, to Charm, to Jen Patrick, and to the baby of Carrie. And to Carrie, wherever you are, hello there, good morning. Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagsubaybay sa programang Insights. Ako ang inyong kabrigada, Belinda Salas-Canlas, nagsasabing patuloy niyo pong subaybayan ang programang Insights. Dahil sa Insights, we grow and learn together. Magandang umaga po sa ating lahat.